talk about the functions. First of all, definition of the function says that you have some kind of input, you do something with this input, you transform it, and we call this transformation function of x, and as a result you have output, this output we call y. And there is one important thing in here. For every input x, there is just one y. So output y is going to be unique. This is the definition of the function. Now let's see how to check if given curve represents a function. To determine if given curve represents a function, you suppose to use vertical line test. How? Here is my function f at x, and I draw vertical lines whenever I want to draw vertical lines, and as a result, I suppose you have just one point of intersection with any vertical line, and I do have just one point of intersection with any vertical line that I draw for this function. So this is the function, this curve represents the function. Now let's see what we have for the circle. Circle is a very nice curve, but it's not a function. Why? First of all, vertical line test says that here we have one point of intersection, but whenever you draw a vertical line between this endpoint and that endpoint, you will get two points of intersection with the curve, right? What these two points of intersection mean? They mean that, for example, for this x, we have this y value and we have that y value. So for one input, you have two outputs. That means that it's not a function anymore based on the definition. So let me remind you how to formulate vertical line test. If given curve has just one point of intersection with any vertical line, this is the function. If given curve has more than one point of intersection with any vertical line that you draw, for example, I draw it here, and again, I have two points of intersection, more than one. This curve does not represent a function.